My coverage of Computex 2024 is brought to you by ASUS, Antec, Thermaltik, and Fractal. Hello everyone and welcome to our first video covering Computex 2024. We have made our way to Taipei, Taiwan, checked into our Airbnb. We spent about a day here so far. We're getting over the jet lag and I just spent about 2 hours watching the entire NVIDIA Computex keynote so you don't have to.
Excellent!
I'm just consoling myself with a bit of malt milk here. My beverage of choice here in Taiwan, and the reason I'm consoling myself is because you might have already heard, there was absolutely nothing about consumer graphics cards, desktop graphics cards in the keynote at all. Nothing about the RTX 50 series, Blackwell-based consumer graphics cards. The closest we got was at one point Jensen walked over and pulled out a graphics card. It was an RTX 4080 Super, as far as I can tell, and he was just using it as a demonstration to say, look, this is a GPU, and then see this DGX system that we build too that costs way more money and that we make way more profit from. That's a GPU too. Aren't you happy now, gamers? We talked about GPUs. But this is really a good lesson, a reminder for those who have forgotten that rumors are just that. They are rumors. And although there was a lot of hype, a lot of buzz leading into Computex that NVIDIA had RTX 50 series GPUs ready to go, NVIDIA said nothing of the sort. NVIDIA didn't even mention that as a topic for the keynote. Usually, if they are going to discuss gaming graphics cards, they will give some indication of that at the beginning. But it was still disappointing when we got to the end of the close to 2 hour presentation and Jensen never said, oh, and one more thing, like let me show you the new graphics card that we're working on. For those of you who are interested in what was discussed, I'm gonna run down my notes really quickly, show you guys some of the videos and stuff, because there was some very visually interesting stuff, as well as a few quirky things that we can poke fun of, I think. So let's get started right from the top. If I can start with something positive, there was an intro montage, which really focused on NVIDIA's employees and all the work that they put in to bring this presentation to life and all the work that they put into the products that they develop. NVIDIA employs close to 30,000 people, and if you look at websites like Glassdoor, they actually have really good company rating. They treat their employees very well, and that is something that I appreciate. The video also highlighted a lot of the collaborative partners that NVIDIA works with in the industry and Taiwan in general. Because Computex takes place at Taiwan, they showed some scenes of Jensen going to the night market, and there was sort of a night market theme running throughout the presentation. My next header was the AI part, and that is pretty much the rest of the presentation. The entire presentation was focused on AI. I'd say the only upshot to contrast the lack of anything about discrete GPUs for gaming desktops was that they didn't go off on a tangent about cars. NVIDIA tends to do that in some of their presentations, and that at least wasn't part of it. Jensen classified AI and AI in general as a restart of the computer industry, and that was the beginning of a lot of very bombastic talk about how important AI is and how cool AI is, and most importantly for Jensen, how AI can save you money. And by you, he doesn't mean like you watching this video or me. He's talking about people who are probably business owners or people who are high up in businesses who are looking to invest tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands or millions of dollars into hardware, NVIDIA hardware specifically, to set up AI data centers. And that, if anything, was the primary overarching theme, was Jensen saying over and over again, look how much money you can save. And it took him about 15 minutes to say AI 30 times or so. And then he finally, of course, dropped his the more you buy, the more you save line. And then he seemed to sort of like pause to wait for the audience to like clap, like because he said his catchphrase or something. And I don't think that really happened. But I will say rip to anyone who's playing the AI drinking game and like taking a shot every time Jensen said AI, because they were probably wasted pretty early in the presentation. But let's talk about an actual cool implementation of AI and the hardware, and that is Earth 2. And Earth 2 is not new, it's been going on for some time, but they're continuing to develop it. It is a digital twin of Earth, basically a full simulation of the Earth. And this was one of those visually really cool videos to watch that I mentioned. They're doing physical simulations, weather simulations to predict things like the paths of hurricanes and typhoons or other extreme weather events. The future of this weather simulation technology, according to the video, is hyper-local forecasting down to the tens of meters. So you could go here and be like, look at the forecast, and then it's like you walk 20 feet to one side and the forecast might be slightly different based on the atmospheric conditions, presumably. They also showed some models of like wind patterns around very tall buildings because we're in Taiwan, so there's a lot of focus on Taipei 101. So that at least was a demonstration of a somewhat practical application of the technology, both the hardware and the software side of things, that would be helpful or beneficial to a regular person like you or me. But after that, my eyes started to gloss over it as they got into more and more specific tasks for AI. And while many of the videos and the demonstrations you could look at and say, well, that's kind of cool, the amount of people who are actually going to be working with that hardware or that software is much more niche. And I think that is why the chat room that I was monitoring, which was the PC World chat, was pretty bored. They're like, I'm bored. This isn't speaking to me at all. And that's because it's not really a presentation that's made for us. It's a presentation that's made for the people who are calling the shots at some of these companies that are doing these very specific things with this hardware. Things got even more nebulous when they started talking about NVIDIA Inference Microservice. The shorthand for this is NIM, and this is about 45 minutes into the presentation. These are pre-trained AI models that are designed to run on CUDA hardware, described as AI in a box, basically containerized models. And I couldn't tell at first if they were talking about something that was hardware-based, but this isn't that. This is software, and apparently it's free too, so that's kind of nice. You download a NIM, different NIMs are built to do different tasks. You could download one that you could talk to, according to the presentation. And again, as long as you have CUDA-enabled hardware, you should be able to run them. Given that this is a software solution, I wasn't quite sure why they're saying that it's in a box, but at least it's free to those who have CUDA hardware. They're planning to use these to replace people eventually, and they showed various NIMs all cobbled together to do various aspects of a customer service agent's job, including a NIM that was generating like the avatar and another one that was handling like the speech and like mapping the speech to the avatar's facial movements so that you could have a AI-generated CS agent that you're talking to and getting mad at because they can't solve your problem, and you don't have to feel bad about getting mad at them because it's an AI-generated thing. So that's a huge advancement. Of course, replacing human jobs or replacing humans in general is one of the big fears that are out there for the advancement of AI. So I was a little bit surprised that the next thing they started talking about was digital humans, and they had a demo showing digital brand ambassadors, digital CS agents, completely AI-generated digital avatars where it's both the avatar as well as the text that's coming out, as well as the speech patterns and everything, all created by AI that can do these various things that previously you had to have a person do. So cool, we just aren't gonna need people anymore once we get enough of these NIMs downloaded and up and running. But I will say that in this demonstration video, the avatars that were talking to people and everything, still kind of creepy. Still haven't quite bridged that uncanny valley to get to the point where I think it's an actual person that's talking there. But it is getting a lot closer. It took Jensen over an hour to even mention Blackwell, which is kind of surprising because that's their current generation that is powering their AI servers and AI solutions that they're trying to sell people. But I could tell chat perked up because he was like, Blackwell. And they're like, ooh, Blackwell. We're looking for Blackwell 50 series GPUs. And then he walked over and took out a GPU. But as I mentioned earlier, it wasn't a new Blackwell GPU. It was just a 4080 Super. And he was just using that to create an equivalency between the GPUs that they used to focus on and the GPUs that they're focusing on now. He was also pulling out the 4080 Super to show by comparison to a Blackwell production board that he brought out, and that was a new thing that they showed off at this presentation. In the previous presentation, they just had a prototype model, so this one was an actual one that they're gonna be selling. NVIDIA likes to throw up graphs in their presentation, and they're often pretty bad, not showing axis lines or just being very, very broad in terms of what they're trying to represent. I'd say the winner for the worst graph in this presentation was when they compared the teraflop progression with their GPUs to Moore's Law, which is really two different things. They're not completely unrelated, but Moore's Law is about transistor density, not like actual compute performance. But NVIDIA had no problem just throwing those up on a graph next to each other to be like, look how much we're beating Moore's Law. Continuing with the video cutaways, they had a Blackwell assembly animation showing the whole family of Blackwell products that they're trying to pitch. This one included a soundtrack that sounds like it might have been AI generated, but Jensen was very proud of this video for some reason. He was like, only NVIDIA could do this, only I could do this, and I'm not sure why, because those were a lot of animations that I feel like I've seen before, and the song was clearly made specifically for this. It had the word Blackwell in the song and everything, but I don't want to focus on that too much though. He talked about the future timeline for upcoming generations of hardware, and this is somewhat relevant to PC gamers because they're using the same GPU microarchitecture, so this should also somewhat align with the progression of GPUs over the next few years. Right now they're on Blackwell. He said next year is Blackwell Ultra, so that's presumably 2025. And he also said they're doing a one-year cycle now for new generations of hardware that come out. But as a result, I think they're also doing mid-tier refreshes. So we're gonna have a Blackwell Ultra next year. I also noted that Apparently it's not Blackwell Super. Super is only good enough for consumer grade graphics cards. Ultra is the word they want to use for their AI stuff. I guess they could have called it Blackwell TI. But after Blackwell Ultra is going to be Rubin, and that's the code name for their next platform, and then that will be succeeded by Rubin Ultra, which is probably going to be 26 for Rubin, 2027 for Rubin Ultra. At this point, we were an hour and a half into the presentation. And I know, like, I've recapped it fairly quickly here. There was a lot of fluff going on, even though Jensen at the beginning was like, I have so much to tell you. It's basically me doing anecdotes about going to the night market in Taipei and stuff. But he did talk about what's next for AI, and that is physical AI, which again, it goes down a path where, like, if you're at all skeptical of AI stuff, it starts to get scary. He said, we have robots, but what we're gonna have is robots that are interacting with other robots so that they can build more robots, and that what could go wrong there? This also led into humanoid robots, and then, of course, Jensen had a bunch of robots come out on stage with him. Cute little ones, of course, and again, this isn't too much different from what we saw at the CES presentation. They rounded things out by bookending the presentation with another homage to Taiwan and a final video towards the very end. Jensen said thank you to everyone, and he took off. And we were all like, where'd you go? You were supposed to say one more thing that you're known for. But perhaps we were just too invested in all the rumors and buzz. Now, this is not to say that there won't still be Blackwell GPUs coming out later this year. Even some of the rumored timelines and speculation about it happening like end of summer or in the fall timeframe, that could still totally easily happen. It's just not what was discussed or revealed at today's Computex keynote. To wrap up this video though, I have three closing thoughts. These are just a couple little things that I wrote down during the course of the presentation. One is there's some weird font they were using the whole time. It was some kind of Comic Sans looking thing, but all caps. I don't know. Did you guys think that was weird? Second, among the Taiwan night market anecdotes, we found out why Jensen has a scar on his face. Apparently when he was like 4.5 or 5, he was at the night market and there was some dude like cleaning a knife and just like slashed his face. That's why he's got a scar. That was probably one of the most interesting parts of the presentation, at least for me. The final thing here, and this is just to sort of summarize what I think NVIDIA's goal was with this presentation, is that NVIDIA and Jensen Huang want to build not just the GPUs. They want to build complete AI solutions, those big DGX machines that they show. And that was another thing that was included in that animation, is this entire data center completely filled out and populated with all NVIDIA hardware. They want to provide not just the GPUs, but also the CPUs, all of the connective hardware, the NVLink hardware, of course, which is also very impressive technology. They want to be a full service solution for AI data centers, and they want to pitch that to investors who want to spend lots of money because according to Jensen, it's not just a GPU, it's an entire AI platform. So that is my quick recap of the NVIDIA Computex 2024 keynote presentation, which unfortunately was disappointingly completely devoid of anything about GPUs, or at least next-gen GPUs. But hopefully you guys who did want to know a little bit more about the AI side of things were able to get that information without having to sit through that entire presentation, because it did get pretty long. I have a lot more videos coming at you real soon for Computex 2024. I want to say a big thank you to my sponsors for this event, ASUS, Thermaltake, Fractal, and Antec. Subscribe if you're not already. Hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you all in the next one.